So, which teams do you think are favorites to win this World Cup? India, New Zealand, Sri Lanka. No. Football World Cup. Let's have a look together then.
Before we begin, I would just like to say that these are the top three reasons that I consider why England is still not one of my favorites to win this World Cup. So, let's begin with number 3. England's dismal performance in the knockouts. Don't be fooled by England's 4th place finish in the 2018 World Cup in Russia or their runner-up finish in the Euros last year. The grim reality is that England as a nation have been terrible at knockout football for some time. But just how terrible, you ask? Well, firstly, they just don't seem to get over one hurdle in particular, that is when they meet a former world champion in the knockout stage. With the exception of England's win over Germany at Wembley during the round of 16 at last year's Euros, England last beat a former world champion in the knockout stage of a World Cup or a Euro way back in 1966 when they beat West Germany in the 1966 World Cup final. Coincidentally, that game also took place at Wembley. Secondly, since that 1966 World Cup, which is England's one and only major tournament win at senior men's level, they have won just 11 knockout games across 20 tournaments. Now, if we were to compare this record with that of other European giants during the same period, since 1966, Germany have won 34 knockout games across 25 tournaments. Yes, 34. As for Italy, they have succeeded in 19. France, a massive 22 knockout wins since 1966. Spain, 14. Portugal, 10. It's worth noting that England's 11 game record is a bit lopsided, as 5 among those 11 victories came in Russia in 2018 and during last year's Euros. Although their recent form is commendable, but they still don't have any trophies to show. So that's England's dismal performance in the knockouts at number 3. Moving on, at number 2, we have England's penalty shootout jitters. England's woes with penalty shootouts is not the world's best kept secret. England's dismal performance in the knockouts is partly due to their inability to succeed in penalty shootouts. England have played 11 matches which have gone to penalties, among which England have only managed to win 3. Among their 11 penalty shootouts, England have faced Germany or West Germany, Portugal and Italy twice, and Spain, Belgium, Argentina, Colombia and Switzerland once. Only one among the 3 wins came in the World Cup, and that too not long ago, against Colombia during the round of 16 of the 2018 World Cup in Russia. England's last penalty shootout was of course during last year's Euros final, which once again ended in sorrow for the English team as they narrowly lost to Italy. And the clock kept on ticking on what is it now? 56 years of hurt. As you can see, when you win only 3 out of 11 penalty shootouts, you're not going to win any tournaments. And this record plays in the mind of every player who steps up to take the penalty for England. Thus, the jitters. No matter how experienced you are or how young a player you are, missing a penalty in a World Cup remains the worst nightmare for a football player, let alone that of an English player. And now, without further ado, we are going to talk about the number one reason why it's still not coming home for England. And that is England's own belief and confidence, or lack thereof, to get the job done. Although England is ranked 5th in the world thanks to their performance in the Euros last year, having said that, they are still not part of my top 5 favorites to win this World Cup. I mean, don't get me wrong, England's a good team. I believe the issue with England is, and it has been that for a while, that when it comes to big tournaments, they lack the self-belief. They lack the self-belief to go all the way. They carry too much extra baggage from their past failures, which doesn't allow them to play freely. Up until the time England as a collective unit doesn't get over this psychological roadblock, I don't see them winning anytime soon. As a neutral fan, I do love watching England play. It also means that I won't shy away from criticizing the team in areas they seem to lack. And this psychological roadblock is one of them. I have made a whole separate video of my top 5 favorites to win this edition of the World Cup. You can check that out at the top right over here.
So, whom do you think? Sorry, cricket game. What did I miss?